Hi, my name is Maddie and I'm an instructor with Wordfence. Today, we're going to take a look at setting up email alerts in Wordfence. Email alerts quickly inform you of security-related events on your site. With Wordfence, whether you're using the free version or one of our paid solutions, we offer a number of options to receive email alerts based on activity or scan findings on your site. Let's first take a look at where to set or change your email address that you'll receive Wordfence alerts at. From the Wordfence, All Options, and the General Wordfence Options section, we see the option Where to Email Alerts. So here, you can enter the email address or multiple email addresses separated by commas that you would like to receive alerts to, and you can save the changes via the button in the top right corner of the page. Let's scroll down and take a look at the Email Alert Preferences section. Here, we are seeing the default email alert preference settings. To learn some more about alert options, take a look at our documentation on alerts linked in the description of this video. There, you can see the scan severity information for all the types of scan findings to make sure you're receiving the alerts that are important to you. For the first few options we are going to look at today, email me if Wordfence is deactivated and email me if the Wordfence web application firewall is turned off, we recommend having these enabled as they are by default. This may alert you to a possible intrusion or other issue on the site, resulting in Wordfence being deactivated or the firewall being turned off. For alert me with scan results of this severity level or greater, this is set to low by default, meaning you would receive email alerts for anything that Wordfence finds during scans. If you prefer to receive fewer email alerts, you might consider setting this to medium or high, where you will only receive alerts of that select severity and higher. Again, you can reference the link to our documentation in the description of this video to see which scan findings are associated with each severity level. Next, the options Alert when an IP address is blocked and Alert when someone is locked out from login are enabled by default. However, if you want to cut down on the frequency of email alerts or you very frequently have users being blocked on the site, you could consider disabling these options to prevent alert fatigue. Alternatively, you might keep these enabled, but adjust the maximum email alerts to send per hour setting here. The option Alert when someone is blocked from logging in for using a password found in a breach is enabled by default and is helpful in the event a higher privileged user, such as an administrator, is blocked by the Wordfence option Prevent the Use of Passwords Leaked in Data Breaches, which you can find located in the Brute Force Protection section at the bottom right here. This requires the user to reset their password before logging in to minimize risk going forward because their current password is on lists used by attackers. Next, if you run a membership site or a site where a number of people are logging in regularly, you might consider disabling the option Alert when the lost password form is used for a valid user. This can cut down on the number of alerts you receive. If you only have a few users on the site, keeping this enabled may help alert you to brute force attacks and give you the opportunity to monitor the attacking IPs via live traffic. Next, we have Alert me when someone with administrator access signs in and Only alert me when that administrator signs in from a new device. If you have only the first of these two options enabled, you would be notified of all administrator logins on the site. If you enable both of these options, you will cut down on the number of emails you receive for admin logins and would be notified only when an administrator logs in from a new device. We recommend having alerts enabled for admin logins in most cases, and these settings give you some control over the number of alerts you receive for administrator logins. The same logic applies to alert me when a non-admin user signs in, and only alert me when the user signs in from a new device. These settings are not as critical on most sites and can be disabled if you have a number of non-admin users logging in regularly in order to cut down on the number of alerts you receive. If you enable both of these, you'll only be notified when a non-admin user logs in from a new device. The option Alert me when there's a large increase in attacks detected on my site is a good option to enable to notify you quickly when your site is under a large attack. In these cases, it is good to log into the site and do a basic check to make sure the site is accessible and not overloaded from the malicious hits that Wordfence blocked from interacting with the site. The maximum email alerts to send per hour option gives you the ability to set a specific number of emails that you will receive per hour. If you set this to zero, an unlimited number of emails can be sent for alerts. This would be fine if you've configured the above settings to reflect the notifications you want to be alerted to. In other cases, you might consider setting a number here between 5 and 10 and setting it as you see fit going forward. The last options we'll take a look at today are just below in the activity report section. Here, with the enable email summary feature checked, we will send an email that summarizes recent security-related events on your site. You can choose whether you want this activity report to be sent every day, every week, or every month. There is also an option to exclude certain directories from the recently modified files section of the activity report. We see two directories that are added here by Wordfence itself, as these directories tend to have normal and frequent file modifications. That's how to set up email alert preferences on your site. If you have any questions, please leave us a comment below. Thanks for watching, and we look forward to securing your WordPress website.